and I read your word. Open up my heart, I want to worship you. When I get quiet and I read your word, open up my heart, I want to worship you. You're my maker, my father, you're my best friend, and you love me, you hear me, that will never end. Hey! I'll seek you, I'll find you, I'll give you my praise, and I will follow you. You're my maker, my father, you're my best friend, and you love me, you hear me, that will never end. I'll seek you, I'll find you, I'll give you my praise, and I will follow you all of my days. All my days.
Hey guys, how's everybody doing today? So, update, I've been eating vegetables like every day. Anybody else doing the Daniel Veggie Challenge? You guys haven't been doing it? Come on, we're supposed to be doing this together.
Are you guys noticing my muscles? I think they're getting so much bigger.
Well, hey, I'm excited to see what other challenges Daniel has for us today. You guys ready for our story? Let's go.
In the second year of King Nebuchadnezzar's rule, he had a troubling dream. He couldn't sleep. So he sent for anyone who claimed to have knowledge, practiced magic, or studied the heavens, because he wanted somebody to tell him what his dream meant. One by one, they came in and stood before him. And King Nebuchadnezzar said, "I had a dream and it troubles me. I want to know what it means, but you must tell me what I dreamed." Then those who studied the heavens said, "King Nebuchadnezzar, may you live forever. You tell us what you dreamed and we'll explain what it means." But the king replied to them, "I have made up my mind. You must tell me what I dreamed, and you must tell me what it means. If you don't, I'll have you cut to pieces and I'll have your house turned into piles of trash. So tell me what I dreamed. Explain it to me. Then I'll give you gifts. I'll reward you. I'll give you great honor. So tell me the dream and tell me what it means." The people pleaded with him, saying, "King Nebuchadnezzar, tell us what you dreamed. Then we'll tell you what it means. No one on earth can do what you are asking. No king has ever asked for anything like that." They explained that the task was too difficult, and those who studied the magic in the heavens had never been asked to do such a thing. There was no one who could tell what the king had dreamed except the gods, and they didn't live among human beings. This made the king very angry, so he ordered that all the wise men in Babylon be put to death, including Daniel and his friends. When Arioch, the commander of the king's guard, found Daniel and was ready to put him to death, Daniel wisely and carefully asked Arioch why the king would give such a terrible order. The commander explained what was going on, and Daniel went to the king and told him he would explain the dream, but he needed more time. Then Daniel returned home and explained everything to his friends, Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah, otherwise known as Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. He asked them to pray that the God of heaven would give him mercy. He wanted God to help him understand the mystery of the king's dream so that he and his friends wouldn't be killed along with the Babylon's other wise men. During the night, God gave Daniel a vision. He showed him what the mystery was all about. Then Daniel praised the God of heaven. Daniel thanked God for his wisdom and power. He thanked him for explaining deep and hidden things. He thanked God for giving him what he needed when he asked for it. And he thanked God for showing him the king's dream. Then he went to Arioch and said, "Don't kill the wise men of Babylon. Take me to the king. I'll tell him what his dream means." So Arioch took Daniel to the king at once and said, "I have found a man among those you brought here from Judah. He can tell you what your dream means." Nebuchadnezzar spoke to Daniel. He called him by his Babylonian name, Belshazzar. Then the king asks, "Are you able to tell me what you saw in my dream? And can you tell me what it means?" Daniel replied, "You asked us to explain a mystery to you, but no wise men can do that. And those who try to figure things out by using magic can't do it either. But there is a God in heaven who can explain mysteries. King Nebuchadnezzar, he has shown you what is going to happen. Now the mystery has been explained to me, not because I have great wisdom than anyone else alive, but because God wants you to know what the mystery means. He wants you to understand what went through your mind." And then Daniel explained the dream and what it meant. King Nebuchadnezzar bowed low in front of Daniel. He wanted to honor him, so he ordered that an offering and incense be offered up to him. The king said to Daniel, "I'm sure your God is the greatest God of all. He is the Lord of kings. He explained mysteries. That's why you were able to explain the mystery of my dream." Then the king put Daniel in a position of authority. He gave him many gifts. He made him ruler over the city of Babylon and the towns around it, and he put him in charge of all the other wise men too. So Daniel asked the king to appoint Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego to help him govern, and the king did as he asked. Daniel himself remained at the royal court. Wow. Okay, crazy turn of events, right? I mean, King Nebuchadnezzar is a little bossy, don't you think? He just told all of those men that they had to know exactly what was on his mind, or he would cut them to pieces and turn their houses to piles of trash. I mean, who does that? But what is so cool about this part of the story is that Daniel was able to step up and do exactly what the king asked him to do. You see, he put his faith over his fear. And you want to know how he did that? Because Daniel trusted God to give him all the information he needed. He had a really scary task ahead of it. And instead of trying to figure it out himself, he knew that God had the answers that he needed. And what did God do? Again, God provided him every bit of wisdom and knowledge that Daniel needed to be able to tell the king what his dream meant. So what does this mean for you and me? Well, it means that we can trust that God's going to do the same thing that he did for Daniel for us too. You know, when we face situations that are really hard and we need wisdom to get through it, we can go to God and ask. He wants us to. In fact, the Bible tells us that he promises to give wisdom to those who ask. But maybe it is that we're too afraid or too scared to do what is right. But God can give us the courage to face those too. I mean, he did it for Daniel, and he'll do it for you too. All you have to do is ask him for help. So if there's one thing I want you to remember from this week, is that God wants you to choose faith over fear, and that you can trust him that he will give the wisdom and knowledge that you need in any situation when you ask him for it. So let's pray together. Father, thank you so much that you are wise and you are understanding and that you are looking out for us in all situations, and that, Lord, that you've made it so we can come to you and that you promise to give us wisdom and courage when we ask for it. So God, this week as we are facing whatever we are facing in our lives, we pray for your courage and your wisdom to do so in a way that's going to glorify and honor you. God, we thank you so much for who you are, and it's in your name we pray. Amen. Oh, it's me, Sarah, and you've just happened upon an episode of Did You Know? So in chapter 2 of the book of Daniel, King Nebuchadnezzar had a super weird dream, and Daniel was the only one who knew what it meant. This is what Daniel had to say about the dream. You looked up and saw a large statue standing in front of you. It was huge and shone brightly, and it terrified you. The head was made of pure gold, and its chest and arms were made of silver. Its stomach and thighs were made of bronze, and its legs were made of iron. Its feet were partly iron and partly baked clay. While you were watching, a rock was cut out, but not by human hands, and it struck the statue on its feet of iron and clay. It smashed them. Then the iron and clay were broken into pieces. So were the bronze, silver, and gold, and all of them were broken to pieces. They became like straw, and the wind blew them away without leaving a trace. But the rock that struck the statue became a huge mountain, and it filled the whole earth. This was the king's dream. But next, Daniel told him exactly what it meant. Here's what he said. You are the greatest king of all. The king of heaven has given you authority and power. He has given you might and glory. He has put everyone under your control. He has also given you authority over the wild animals and the birds in the sky. It doesn't matter where they live. He has made you ruler over them all. You are the head of gold. After you, another kingdom was taken over. It won't be as powerful as yours. Next, a third kingdom will rule over the whole earth. The bronze part of the statue stands for that kingdom. Finally, there'll be a fourth kingdom, and it will be as strong as iron, and iron breaks and smashes everything to pieces, and the fourth kingdom will crush and break all the others. You saw that the feet and toes were made out of iron and baked clay, and the fourth kingdom will be divided up, but it'll still have some of the strength of the iron. That's why you saw the iron mixed with the clay. The toes were partly iron and partly clay. And the fourth kingdom will be partly strong and partly weak. You saw the iron mixed with baked clay, and the fourth kingdom will be made up of all kinds of people. They won't hold together any more than iron mixes with clay. In the time of those kings, the God of heaven will set up a kingdom. It'll never be destroyed, and no other nation will ever take it over. It'll crush those other kingdoms. It'll bring them to an end, but it will last forever. That's what the vision of the rock cut out of the mountain means. Human hands didn't cut the rock. It broke the statue to pieces. It smashed the iron, bronze, clay, silver, and gold. Then Daniel told the king, "The great God has shown you what will take place in the days to come. The dream is true, and you can trust the meaning that I have given you." You see, Daniel and his friends prayed and asked God, and God answered their prayers. God allowed Daniel to do the impossible. He was the only one who could tell the king what his dream was and what it meant. And King Nebuchadnezzar believed Daniel's interpretation of the dream, and he recognized Daniel's God, our God, as being the greatest God of all, the Lord of Kings who can explain mysteries. This increased the king's trust in Daniel, and he put Daniel and his friends in charge of the city of Babylon and in the towns around it. And now you know.
Well, that was a good story. I wish I could interpret dreams because I had the weirdest one last night. You see, I was at this grocery store and I was running and I had a can of Pringles in my hand and I saw my great aunt Cindy and she was like, "Chase!" Wait, you guys don't want to hear this? Anyways, it would be awesome if I could interpret dreams like that. Isn't it so cool to know that God will give us the wisdom and knowledge we need when we need it? Like when we're stuck and we don't know what to do. Doesn't matter what the situation is, if we'll stop and pray and ask for help, God promises us to help us make the right choice and he'll give us the courage to follow through, just like he did for Daniel. All right, guys, I had a great time today and I hope you did too. Maybe try the veggie diet out because I think it's working for me. And if anyone can interpret dreams, maybe give me a call. All right, bye guys.
Are you guys ready to play the review game? Here we go. Question number one, what was bothering King Nebuchadnezzar? Was it A, too many people were eating vegetables, B, a dream, or C, no one could tell him if he looked good in his new robe? Do you know the answer? The answer is B. King Nebuchadnezzar had a dream about a statue and wanted to know what it meant. Question number two, true or false? Daniel knew right away what the king's dream meant. Is that true or false? The answer is false. Daniel asked his friends to pray and then asked God to give him the wisdom to interpret the dream before he knew what it meant. Last question, here we go. Question number three. How did King Nebuchadnezzar respond when Daniel interpreted his dream? Did he A, praise God and reward Daniel? B, threw Daniel into the lion's den? Or C, had Daniel's house turned into piles of trash? The answer is A. King Nebuchadnezzar praised God and rewarded Daniel for interpreting the dream. Great job, you guys. Thanks for playing.